If any of your buddy in your party speaks undercommon. Sounds gross.
Hello and welcome back to the Bestiary Monster Manual A through Z. I'm Emmy.
And in some dark, forgotten history of the world that has been destroyed because of its very nature, I might have been called James.
And we are discussing today
the Grimlock.
They're weird. They're weird and gross.
They're horrible and awesome, and I love them.
They're mostly lore. So as far as fighting one of these guys go, we'll just kind of get it out of the way. They're a quarter challenge rating. They've got a club. We'll go into some more of their stuff later, but they're not hard. They're just really interesting.
These are one of those species, cultures, societies, I think all of those apply, where... Yeah. This is an example of how extremely terribly the Illithid Empire ruined the universe.
Yeah, for the hot minute that the Illithid Empire ruled everything, their influence was corrupted. And I think it's important to remember when you're ever looking at a creature that spent a lot of time with them, that you're not looking at the before, you're definitely looking at the after. Things that are even just spending time with them start to change. The Grimlocks were once human, and if you look at the art, not so much anymore.
Well, I mean, certainly not anymore, but you can see perhaps where that initially came from. So human societies under the influence of the Illithid Empire were susceptible to this corrupting influence and succumbed to this cannibalistic cult, almost. Illithids consume brains. They are our overlords. We must do the same. And the skin, the distorted jaw, by the way, Grimlocks have slowly evolved out of the need for eyes, because they have largely lived underground, which we'll get to in a minute. But they have these pointed ears and enhanced senses.
The mouth is really, I think, thing that really sticks with me with that Illithid influence. We'll, of course, talk about this more when we get to eye, but Illithids have that round mouth with extremely pointed teeth, and that's what these guys' mouth reminds me of, that, but almost laid on top of humans. And like you were saying, this is largely due to the fact that they just spent a lot of time with them. They were the people who brought other humans to the Illithid. They worshipped them, and they would bring Illithids their food. And then when the Illithids were done with the brains, they believed it was holy then to consume the bodies. And then slowly over time, between that and the corruption of the Illithids, they became this monster, and they're still around, and they're still fighting the Illithid Wars thousands of years ago, still.
This is the crazy thing, really, about the Grimlocks. I mean, there's a lot to talk about in terms of weird stuff, but it's been thousands of years since the Illithid Empire collapsed after the rebellion of Gith. Gith lives.
Maybe.
There's people, creature, species. I don't know what to call them, frankly.
They kind of ride that line. They have a language. They're generally intelligent, but they're not doing anything other than what the Illithids told them to do thousands of years ago. They're still dragging people down into the Underdark, whether or not to a living Illithid or not. So you might find these guys hanging around an Illithid lair with an actual living elder brain or a couple of Illithid in it. They might still be doing that, but...
Or might be nothing.
Yeah, like they might just be doing exactly what they've been doing. They're just doing that
because they've developed this kind of society and almost religion, in fact, around the idea of doing this.
Yeah. It's holy to just continue to bring people back to maybe this pile, and maybe one day the Mind Flayers will come back and, like, devour the people. I don't know. They're weird.
It's horrible.
It's horrible. And that's, I think, largely what can be interesting about these guys. Because they have that kind of rich lore, they're never around a place that isn't important. Wherever they are is generally important. They were driven underground, much like the rest of what remains of material plane Illithid society, which is not a lot. So they've been driven underground, but even then, those places are kind of important. Maybe they're underneath an old Illithid temple. Maybe they're next door to a current one. They're never not near something important or an area that was important because once there were Illithid here.
Right.
So they are just another staple of something that's just long dead.
Yeah. And we often talk about how creatures are one of the best ways of showing ambiance and a feeling of a place for players. And
these guys are pretty good at that.
Yeah, great example. It's like if these guys turn up and either your players already know or later find out what these guys are, that's going to raise so many questions.
Yeah.
Why are they there? What were they doing there? Were they there originally? Or did they come there recently? Like, just like...
It's so much campaign fodder. And you could also have a lot of fun role-playing these guys to an extent. I mean, you could very easily use these guys as an overwhelm monster and just have, you know, 1,000 Grimlocks just fall out of a door somewhere.
Which could be awesome, by the way.
Oh, like, yeah.
You know, you should never just throw this almost never throw this one at a time at your party. This should be hordes descending upon your players.
If you have one, it's going to be more of, again, a meaningful thing. Like, there's one. Oh no, there's probably 1,000 more. They are fairly easy to miss because they have stone camouflage, so they're very good at hiding. They're pretty perceptive. They can smell and hear you very, very well.
So that kind of trope of they have no sight, but then their other senses are enhanced enormously.
So they do just fine finding you. Again, they do speak. They speak undercommon. So they may very well just drag a party back.
Yeah.
For some purpose. They could absolutely overwhelm and just drag you back. They could talk to you. This could be a lot of fun, I think, for a DM to role play and get into the meat of it. I hated it as I made the joke. They're cannibals.
Get into the meat of it. Do it. The meat. Get into it.
See, again, that's what a Grimlock says. It would be fun, but it's gross.
It wouldn't sound like that.
How do you know?
Doesn't have it. hey, Emmy, if you're going to say that undercommon is a charismatic British accent, then we're going to have problems. Hi there. Thank you for joining us again here at the Bestiary, Monster Manual A2Z. If you were to grim a lock or lock a grim, which would you prefer? What do those terms mean to you? Let us know in the comments down below. While you're there, please do subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. We really appreciate it. You'll find our social media presences all over the internet, because the internet is a very broad and expansive thing, and isn't it fun? And check out some other of the things we've done here, and join us next time when we are going to talk, or at least start talking about, hags.